Hey guys, today I'm going to answer the question whether the Mac Pro 4.1 or the Mac Pro 5.1 is still worth it in 2008, because that's a question that showed up over and over online. And I'm going to answer this for you today in the following way. Now guys, I have used this iMac for a couple of weeks right now. And so in these couple weeks, I got really, really experienced. Right now, the way it's sitting there is I reverted it back. Maybe I can just quickly open it up for you into the original state when I ordered it on eBay. And maybe as you can see, it came with the stock graphics card, which is very good. And 6 gigs of memory, plus up here 2 hard disk drives. So you can already notice that for 2008, that might not, at least at the first look, to be the most desirable configuration. And the question was, the justified question was raised whether that it makes any sense to buy something like this for $300, $400 on eBay used, when this is a machine from 2009 or 2010. But let me tell you, from all the research that I did and what I encountered online, this is totally easily, totally easily able to remedy all the issues that the Mac Pro 4.1 and 5.1 comes with. So you can do a lot of things. For example, you can fix the Bluetooth issue, and I'm gonna show this to you in part one, and you should be able to see this in the navigation down here. You can also, with the Mac Pro 4.1, there was an issue that I encountered that you couldn't install High Sierra. And in part two, I'm gonna show you how to install High Sierra very easily. Then another issue is, maybe you can see this here. This is a brand new 1 terabyte SSD. And so, not sure whether you're already aware of this, but the Mac Pro comes with a SATA, with 4 SATA 2 connectors. So what happens when you plug in a solid state drive in one of these connectors, or up here behind there is an optical drive and a free SATA connector as well. You can just pull this out and plug the SSD in here as well.
But in any case, you won't get the speed. So I got an adapter card, and in part three, I'm going to show you how to set this up. And then another thing is, obviously,
the stock graphics card. I mean, the stock graphics card works well and you can use it. It drives a HD display just fine. But realistically speaking, I think most people will also want to change this graphics card, because obviously the Mac Pro is like a machine that's probably primarily used by creative professionals, or people who aspire to maybe become creative professionals, such as people who do graphics design or who like video editing like me, or maybe audio production. So obviously when you create a video for YouTube, you don't want to always spend like hours rendering this on a system. That's like cumbersome. So that's why I'm going to show you how to replace the graphics card and what you have to pay attention to when replacing the graphics card, so that you have an easy time, and also what graphics card to choose and what performance differences you can expect.
Now, personally, I picked this one. You can pick faster ones. It's absolutely no big deal, but I wanted to keep it a little bit in a budget, a little bit like a budget build. And then in part five, I'm also gonna show you how to replace the memory. And in part six, I'm still waiting for the CPU. I'm also going to show you how to upgrade the CPU, because what I noticed when researching this, there are lots of little details where you potentially can make mistakes when picking a graphics card, or when picking a CPU, or when buying memory. And I'm going to show you these details in these parts. So if you're interested in one particular part, just you can use the links in the description below, where you are basically jumping to the corresponding video.
And yeah guys, that's about it. I mean, you see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 videos in the pipeline for you that you can really use to become a Mac, almost like a Mac genius in no time. And I'm gonna transfer the knowledge to you real fast. And right now we are at the conclusion part. The conclusion for me so far is that if you are a user that just wants a computer that you just take out of the box, put on your desk, and you can use right away and get started with your creative work, then the old Mac Pros might not be the best solution for you, and you might be better off just paying more for buying just a new Mac. However, if you don't mind to following a tutorial like this, and if you don't mind working on your computer, then Mac Pro 4.1 and 5.1 can be, in my opinion, a really good value. This is why I got this system, because I think it's an excellent value and can really help me to save some money, because we all know the new Mac Pros are insanely expensive. And also, one thing that I really noticed is, for example, if you have like an iMac, the iMacs have become so thin, and I'm really questioning the philosophy of the Apple engineers. Why, maybe if you're an Apple engineer, please answer this question to me. Why are you making the devices thinner and thinner and thinner? Doesn't this present you with thermal challenges? I mean, you might say, oh my God, this thing is so big, but in my playbook, wow, big is good, because big, you can easily access everything, you can upgrade it. If I don't like the graphics card, I just swap it out, it's easily accessible. If you have an iMac or something like that, that's a totally different scenario. So for me, I like these old systems, and if you don't mind putting in some work, then I think this is a really secret tip and an awesome value. Otherwise, like I said, if you just want to take it out of the box, then stick with the normal system. So without further ado, let's jump into these videos. I see you in the next video, and I hope these tutorial series will help you very much in making the decision whether you should purchase this or not, or if you have already purchased it, to solve your issue, because I had to do a lot of learning, and I had to spend many, many hours reading and watching other videos to gather all this information and make my system work the way it works right now. So let's get started with the number one issue that I found, and that was the Bluetooth fix. So let's fix the Bluetooth issue, and I see you in a video.
And yeah, like I mentioned before, this is a six-part video series, and next up we're gonna have a look at the Bluetooth issue, how to fix that, and yeah, you're invited to use the navigation below. And more and more people have already subscribed to my YouTube channel, because I deliver so much useful content there. So don't miss out on that, or check out my free online training course in which I reveal some of the most awesome case studies of how people became super successful online.